I've received a lot of direct death threats. I've had to go to trial and testify against someone sending me death threats. You know, people put images of me with "kill him" on the internet.
I pulled out my video camera and I just did my best to try to watch the activists. I knew that David and Brad had bought Molotov cocktail stuff. I was texting the Bureau, like, emergency, emergency, emergency.
Two Texas men are charged with plotting to attack police with Molotov cocktails.
The Molotov cocktails would not have been made had it not been for Brandon Darby.
To say that Brandon Darby didn't give those guys a fair chance would be an understatement. It's a travesty what he did.
When you interview people who know Brandon Darby, you realize everybody kind of has a different idea of who he is.
So for residents that want to stand in the homes, they want to stand in the homes even if a bulldozer is going to come, I personally commit to being in that house with them.
After the storm, Brandon was considered this hero, this god. He was the symbol of what radical activism could do.
As a revolutionary, I really believed at some point I was going to join a revolutionary movement. So we go to Venezuela. It was beautiful, you know, this revolutionary fervor. It's what I'd always dreamed of. It was my dream.
How does a radical activist end up working for the FBI as an informant?
My entire life, it had been so foreign to talk to the FBI.
Without Brandon Darby, these guys would have thrown Molotov cocktails.
Those kids would not have built those if Brandon had never been involved.
Brandon Darby has been in similar situations where had the state known about it, he would have been doing prison time.
He's been living a double life for years. What is the truth?